Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So in this video we'll solve exclusively numerical problems related to most economical sections. So the derivations for most economical sections for different geometries like rectangle, trapezoid and circular I have showed in my previous video. People who have missed it can watch again. So in this video we'll solve problems related to most economical sections. So let's see the first model of problem. A rectangular channel carries water at the rate of 500 liters per second when bed slope is 1 in 3000. Find the most economical dimensions of the channel if C is equal to 60. So it's very clearly mentioned that he's asking find the most economical dimensions. Means indirectly he's telling that the section is most economical rectangular section. And we require the values of B and D. Okay. So let's start off writing the given data first. Whatever is the model of problem, you have to start writing with the given data. So first given data is Q. So Q is given as 500. Liters per second, means convert into meter cube per second, so 500 by 1000, which is 0.5 meter cube per second. Then bed slope is given I, which is 1 by 3000. 1 in 3000 or 1 by 3000 means the same. And he gave Chessy's constant C as 60. He's asking us to calculate the value of B as well as D. Okay, so to before calculating the unknowns, first let's write the conditions for most economical section for rectangle. Why? Because it's already given most economical dimensions, means it's a most economical rectangular section. So for most economical rectangular section, we have the two conditions, right? Well, let's write those two conditions. What are they? First one is B is equals to 2 times D, and second condition is M is equals to D by 2. Now I have both B and D unknown, so that's why I will write the entire equation only in terms of one unknown, so that I can solve it and later I will calculate the other unknown. Okay, now first I'll calculate area of the channel or area of flow. So area of flow, A is equal to, what is the formula? B into D. So A is equals to, but what is B? For most economical section, 2 times D. So this is 2D into D. So which implies A is equals to 2D square. So keep this aside. Now however, M is already D by 2. So now take the equation of Q is equals to AC root MI. This is the formula for discharge. So Q is how much? 0.5. What is A? 2D square into what is C? 60 into root of, this is D by 2 into, what is I value? 1 by 3000. So let's simplify the equation. This is 2d square into 60 into under root of d by 6000. Okay, so I'll just simplify the equation. It will be 0.5 is equals to 2d square into 60 into, this is root d, means d power 1 by 2, okay, by under root of 6000. Okay, I'm just trying to split the root. Okay, now what I'll get, 0.5 is equals to 2 into, here you have d square, here you have d power 1 by 2. So take the LCM, 2 plus 1 by 2 will be 5 by 2. D power 5 by 2 into 60 divided by root over 6000. So from here the only unknown is d power 5 by 2. So let's write for d power 5 by 2. What will be d power 5 by 2 equal to? 0.5 into root over 6000 divided by 2 into 60. So first let me calculate the value of d power 5 by 2, then I'll calculate d power 2 by 5. So I got d power 5 by 2 as 0.3227. So from here, what will be d equal to? 0.3227 to the power of 2 by 5. 5 by 2 will come to say 2 by 5. So after checking, I got the answer is 0.636 meters. So this is the value of depth of flow. Now I can calculate width, right? Therefore, what is B is equals to 2 times D. So this is equal to 2 into 0.636. So let me check how much will be the my width. Yeah, it is 1.272 meters. So we are done with calculation of most economical dimensions. We calculated width and depth. So you can write here at the bottom. Therefore, width of the channel is 1.272 meters. And therefore, depth of flow is 0.636 meters. This is how you need to solve for most economical rectangular section. Another model of problem will be like, they'll give you the values of B and D, they'll ask you to calculate I. So again you have to come back to the same formula. Here only I will be unknown, so you can calculate I. Okay, like this you have to solve for rectangular section. Now let's see the next model of problem related to trapezoidal channel. So we'll have the question. A trapezoidal channel has side slope of 1 horizontal is to 2 vertical and the bed slope is 1 in 2000. If area is 42 meter square, find the dimensions of the section. If it's most economical, determine the discharge of the most economical section if C is 60. Right, in this problem we have again the same. It is a most economical trapezoidal section as it is given in the question. He's asking us to calculate width and also the depth of flow, means you require the values of B and D, and also he's asking you to calculate Q also. Okay, it's similar as we have done just now for rectangle. Let's solve. First, let's start off with the given data. Yeah, let's write the given data first. What is given? Side slope is given, means N is equals to how much? 1 H is to 2V, 1 horizontal to 2 vertical it's given, means it is simply 1 by 2. Okay, next. Bed slope is given, means I is equals to 1 by 2000. Right. Next, area is given, capital A, 42 meter square. And also, C is given, chassis constant, which is 60. He is asking us to calculate B and D and also Q. Okay. Once we get BD, we can calculate Q. Now, let's start off with calculation of B and D. So, how to proceed first? Why? Because we have two unknowns of B and D. You know how to solve for trapezoidal channel, right? I have told in my most economical section video for deriving. What was the area formula? It is AB plus CD by 2 into D. Okay. And what was the formula for CD? It is AB plus 2 times BE, where BE is ND. Okay. First, let's calculate BE. So, BE is equal to what was the formula? N into D. N is how much? 1 by 2. So, 1 by 2 into D, which is 0.5 D, is your BE value. So, can you tell what will be CD now? So, CD is equals to AB plus 2 times BE. So, this is equal to B plus 2 times 0.5 into D. So, how much will be my CD now? It will be directly B plus D. That's the top width formula. Okay. Next, once you get top width and width, bottom width we are assuming it as B. Now let's calculate the area. So area of flow A is equals to, what is the formula? AB plus CD by 2 into D. That's the formula. So A is equals to, what is AB? B, small b, plus what is CD? B plus D by 2 into D. So AB, A will be equal to, it is B plus B, which is 2B. 2b plus d, this is whole into d by 2. Okay, so how much will I get now if I just multiply or just leave it like this? And in our question already area is given as 42 meter square, right? So but a is equals to how much? 42 meter square. So let's equate now. Therefore 42 is equals to 2b plus d into d by 2. Okay, so from here 42 into 2 is how much? 84. So 84 is equals to 2b plus d into d. Okay, and if you can just leave it like this, let it be like this, so that once we get the values of b and d, we will substitute. Take this as some equation number 1. Okay, this is my area value, or else after getting area I substituted and I ended here. Right, now after getting area, what's our next concept? Calculation of wetted perimeter. For calculation of wetted perimeter, we have right angle triangle BEC and you have to start solving for BC. But before that, let's write the conditions of most economical section for trapezoid. For trapezoidal section, to be most economical, what is our first condition? Half of the top width is equals to one of the sloping side. So it is B plus 2 ND by 2. I'm just normally writing the original condition, D root N square plus 1. And what is our second condition in terms of hydraulic radius? B by 2. Okay, now let's not talk about this. Let's simplify the first equation. So this will be B plus 2 into what is N? 1 by 2, which is 0.5 into D by 2 is equals to D under root of N is 1 by 2, right? So 0.5 square plus 1. Okay, so now I'll just try to simplify this. So this b plus d by 2 is equals to d under root of what is 0.5 square? It is 0.25 plus 1 is 1.25. Okay, right. So just cross multiply. B plus d will be equal to 2d into under root of 1.25. Okay, so b plus d will be equal to it will be d into, I'll do 2 into under root of 1.25. So 2 into under root of 1.25 comes out to be root 5, which is 2.23. okay, from here b plus d is equals to 2.23 d. So from here, get all d terms on one side, this d will go there. So what will be b equal to? 2.23 d minus d. So how much will be my b equal to now? 1.23 d. yeah, I got a relation. You remember our equation 1? Now in the place of b, you just substitute this 1.23 d in equation number 1, substituting the value of b in equation 1, okay, which equation I got after substitution of area. So 84 is equals to 2 into b is how much? 1.23 d plus d into d. Now everything is in terms of d, you will get very easily the value of d. I'm simplifying. 84 is equals to 2 into 1.23, 2.46 d plus d into d. So this becomes 84 is equals to 2.46 d plus d is 3.46, 3.46 d into d is 3.46 d square. So from here, what is d square equal to? 84 by 3.46. so can you tell me what is d now? Under root of 84 by 3.46. let me solve and I'll tell you the value of d. So this answer came out to be 4.92 meters. So I'm ready with the value of d. So once I'll get the value of d, can I get the value of b? Yes. How? We have the relation b is equal to 1.23 into d, right? So let's use that relation. So b is equals to 1.23 into what is d value? Just now we got 4.92. so let's calculate what is b equal to into 1.23 into 4.92. yeah, the answer came out to be 6.05 meters. So width is already ready, so our question is done. But still he asked us to calculate discharge also. So let's calculate discharge. What's the formula? Q is equals to AC root MI. So I think better we'll calculate first area. So what was area we got? Okay, area is already ready, so no issues. Area is 42. C is how much? 60. M is equals to d by 2, right? So let's calculate m value. D is 4.92 by 2. So 2.46 meters is our m. And what is I equal to? 1 by 2000. So I think all the values are ready. Let's quickly start off. Q is equals to 42 into 60 into root of m, 2.46 into 1 by 2000. So let's solve for Q. It's very simple. 42 into 60 into root of 2.46 divided by 2000. All right, it is 88.37 meter cube per second. This is how you need to solve for most economical trapezoidal sections. Let's see another model related to most economical trapezoidal section. The question is, a trapezoidal channel with side slope of 1:1 has to be designed to convey 9 meter cube at a velocity of 1.5 meter per second so that the amount of concrete lining for the bed and the sides is minimum. Calculate the area of lining required for 1 meter length of the canal. Now see, here nowhere in the question it is told like it's a most economical section or the dimensions are most economical, but still it is a case of most economical sections. Why? Because it's given the amount of concrete lining for the bed and sides is minimum. So when will be the amount of lining be minimum for your sides and the bed? How much, when will be your concrete lining minimum? When the dimensions are minimum, right? When the weighted perimeter is minimum. When will be the weighted perimeter minimum? Where it's the most economical section. So that's the link there, okay? He's asking us to calculate what's the area of lining required for the sides and for the base. Okay, let's start off. I'll start writing the given data first. So what is given to us? Side slope is given, which is n. 1 is to 1 means 1 by 1, which is equal to 1. Next, discharge is given to us, q, which is 9 meter cube per second. Next, velocity is given, v is 1.5 meter per second. Okay, he's asking area of lining, right? Once you have q and v, our first step is calculation of area. How do we calculate area? We have the formula q equal to a into v. So from there, a equal to q by v. So it's 9 by 1.5. The answer is 6. 6 meter square is your area. Okay, for trapezoidal channel to be, or trapezoidal section to be most economical, what's our first condition? Half of top width must be equal to one of the sloping side, means b plus 2nd by 2 is equal to d root of n square plus 1. And what's our second condition? Hydraulic radius is d by 2. Now again, I'll start adopting the first formula. Here nowhere the values of b and d are given. Again, they will be like unknown only. So again, I'll take this condition and I'll start solving. So b plus 2 into what is n value? 1. So b plus 2d by 2 is equal to d into under root of 1 square plus 1. So what will be this now? B plus 2d by 2 is equal to d into root 2. Correct? Under root of 1 plus 1 is 2. So from here, b plus 2d will be equal to 2 root 2 into d. So b plus 2d is equals to 2 root 2 value is 2.828 d. So from here, what will be b value? Send this that side. So 2.828 d minus 2d. So finally, what will be b? It will be 0.828 d. Okay, let's have this first relation. Now again, we will take the formula of area, and again we will equate the value with 6, and we will try to get a relation, and again same as we have solved in the earlier problem, right? Therefore, area of flow A is equals to, what is the formula? AB plus CD by 2 into D. I think we didn't calculate CD first. Let's calculate CD. CD formula is what? AB plus twice BE. So this is AB means B plus 2 times BE means N into D. So this is B plus 2 into 1 into D means 2D. Okay, that's your CD. Now let's see for A. A is B plus 2D by 2 into D. So which implies A is equals to, this becomes 2B plus 2D by 2. Sorry, this is 2B by 2 into D. So from here, A is equals to, here 2 will be common, cancel out, you will be left with B plus D into D. Now, what is A? 6. 6 is equal to B plus D into D. But already what is B? 0.828D, right? Let's substitute here. So, substituting, B is equal to 0.828D. Take this as equation number 1 in equation 1. So 6 is equal to 0.828d plus d into d. So which implies 6 is equal to, this becomes 1, 1.828d square. So from here, d square is equal to 6 by 1.828. So d will be under root of 6 by 1.828. Let's calculate d now. So the answer came out to be 1.811 meters. So once you get the value of D, you can calculate the value of B. So therefore, B is equals to, what was the formula? 0.828 into 1.811. So let me check what's the value of B now. B is 1.5 meters. Now I got the values of B and D. So what's next I can calculate? Here he's asking area of lining. Area of lining formula is given as, and one minute, check the question once. It is given as area of lining required for 1 meter length of canal. So generally area can be written as perimeter into one of the dimension, correct? Here one of the dimension is already into length. Why? Because it's asking per meter. So you can write area of lining as wetted perimeter into unit length. Why? Because it's asking for 1 meter length. So now once we get the value of wetted perimeter, we can calculate the area of lining. So wetted perimeter P is equals to, what is the formula for P? See this diagram, what's the formula for P? It is AD plus AB plus BC. AD plus AB plus BC. I already gave you the formula of BC, right? By applying Pythagoras theorem, your AD and BC will be same. So AD is equals to BC is equal to, it will be D root n square plus 1. How this came? Just apply Pythagoras theorem from the right angle triangle BC. So D into under root of, here n is 1. So 1 plus 1, this is equal to root 2 into D, which is equal to root 2 into, what was D value we got? 1.811. So I'll just get the value of AD and BC, which is equal to root 2 into 1.811. Root 2 into 1.811. Yeah, it came out to be 2.56. Okay, meters, that's the length. Now wetted perimeter P will be equal to 2.56 plus, what is AB value? AB is nothing but your width. With how much it came? 1.5 plus 1.5 plus 2.56. So let's calculate what is P now. So it is directly 1.5 plus 2 times 2.56. yeah, it came out to be 6.62 meters. This is the wetted perimeter. Therefore area of lining is equals to wetted perimeter into length of canal. This is the actual formula. Here he asked us to calculate for 1 meter length of canal. So this will be equal to 6.62 into 1 meter. So this is already 6.62 meter square. This is the area of lining required. This is how you need to calculate. Some will give you the cost also. So according to that, you can calculate the cost also. So this sort of problem is a little bit different. When come in most economical trapezoidal section only, it is a little bit different. So like this, you have to stop the problem. Alright people, let's see the next model of problem related to circular channel. The rate of flow of water through a circular channel of diameter 0.8 meters is 200 liter per second. Find the slope of the bed of the channel for maximum velocity. Take C is equal to 50. So it is given condition for maximum velocity. In most economical circular channel, we have two types, two conditions. One is condition for maximum velocity and one is condition for maximum discharge. So this is related to condition for maximum velocity. So now let's start off writing the given data. So right, what is given first? Diameter is given, capital D, which is 0.8 meters. Then we have Q given to us, which is 200 liter per second. So convert this into meter cube. So 200 by 1000. So this is 0.2 meter cube per second. Okay. Now, C value is given to us, which is 50. Is asking us to calculate the value of I, bed slope. Okay. So for this, it is given as condition for maximum velocity. If you remember the condition for maximum velocity which I have taught you in the last video, this was our condition for maximum velocity. After deriving all the values, we got 2 theta is 257 degrees 30 minutes and theta is 128 degrees 45 minutes. I told you to remember this value, theta 128 degrees 45 minutes. Okay. And I also told you, remember another condition where depth of flow, small d is 0.81 times capital D, and also m is equal to 0.3 times d. I told to remember these three conditions, both for velocity and for discharge. In discharge also we have theta 154 degrees, and there also we have small d, and there also we have in terms of m. So we have to remember all these three values. Now I'll try to apply these three conditions, that is theta value and depth of flow condition and hydraulic radius, so that I can calculate the unknowns. Okay, so now let's start off. So for maximum velocity, first condition is theta is equal to 128 degrees 45 minutes, which is 128.75 degrees. This is the first condition. What is our second condition? Depth of flow is 0.81 times capital D. And next condition is hydraulic radius is 0.3 times capital D, which is diameter. These three conditions are very, very important for us. Okay, now using these three conditions, let us solve the unknowns. Alright, now let's start off. See, depth of flow is 0.81 times capital D. Already capital D is there for us ready. So we can calculate small d, we can also calculate m also. Let's calculate for small d, which is depth of flow. So 0.81 into 0.8. So let me get the value of small d, 0.81 into 0.8. Yeah, it is 0.648 meters. This is the depth of flow. Next, let's calculate m, which is hydraulic radius, which is 0.3 times d. So 0.3 into 0.8. This comes out to be 2.4 meters. Sorry, it's 0. Okay, I'll just cut off and write. Please don't mind. 0.24 meters. That's your m. Okay, now let's calculate wetted perimeter P. Wetted perimeter P is equals to, what is the formula? 2 into R into theta. So you know theta, I told, when you're applying theta without any trigonometric function, you have to convert it into radians. In the derivation already I converted into radians, which was 2.247 radians. If you don't remember, I'll tell you how to do. So theta is 128.75 degrees into pi by 180. This comes out to be 2.247 rads. Okay, now you can start. What is R? If diameter is 0.8, what will be R equal to? D by 2. So 0.8 by 2, which is equal to 0.4 meters. Now, let's calculate P. Therefore, P is equals to 2 into 0.4 into 2.247. Let me check how much I'll get the value of P. So, the P value is 1.797 meters. Which is almost 1.8 meters is wetted perimeter. Now we can calculate area by using area formula, if you remember, which is R square into theta minus sine 2 theta by 2. Instead of going for that bigger formula, we know the formula of M, right? M is A by P. So from here you can calculate A, right? So what will be A equal to? M into P. I used hydraulic radius formula. So M is already ready with me, which is 0.24 into, what is P? 1.797. Now I'll get the value of area. Yeah, the answer is 0.431 meter square is the area of the circular channel. Okay, and now he asks us to calculate the value of I. Now this will be easier once you get the I value you need to calculate. Now let's take the formula of Q equal to AC root M into I. So I'll substitute all the values. What is Q given to us? 0.2. What is A? 0.431. Into what is C given to us? 50. Into root of what is M? 0.24. Into we don't know the value of I. So now keep it like this. Now under root of 0.24 into I is equal to 0.2 divided by 0.431 into 50. Okay, so from here root I will be equal to 0.2 by 0.431 into 50 into under root of 0.24. Okay, let's calculate the value of I root I first. Okay. So I got root I as 0.0189. So from here I is the square on both sides. You will be getting 0.0189 whole square, which is 3.58 into 10 power minus 4. But you can't leave the bed slope like this. You have to write 1 and something. If you see the earlier problems also, our slope will be given as 1 by 2000 or 1 in 2000, something like that. It will be represented as 1 in. So you can't leave the decimal like this. So for this, what I'll tell you is, remember this point. See, now like this, I got the answer 3.58 into 10 power minus 4. So what you have to do is, you people. So this is our answer, right? So what you have to do is 1 divided by answer. You got 2793, right? So now you should write, therefore I is equal to 1 in 2793. Like this you have to write. So divide this decimal with 1. 1 divided by this decimal of I will give you some value. So you should write 1 in that value. Like this you have to write for slope. It's not only in most economical conditions, it is everywhere. With the Chess's formula you do, with the rectangular channel you do, trapezoid you do, whatever you do, wherever you are getting this I like this, just 1 divided by this decimal value will yield in some answer like this 2793 or something very closer to this. You should write 1 in that value. So this is one model of solving the problems with respect to condition of maximum velocity. Alright, let's see the next and last problem. Find the maximum discharge of water through a circular channel of diameter 2 meters when the bed of the slope of the channel is laid at 1 in 1500, take C is equal to 50. Now this problem is related to maximum discharge condition of circular channel. He's asking us to calculate the maximum discharge, means directly is asking us take the maximum discharge condition and calculate the value of Q. Okay, let's start off writing the given data first. Yeah, what is that given to us? Diameter is given, capital D, which is 2 meters. Next, a bed of this slope of the channel, which is I, 1 by 1500 is given. Next, Chess's constant is given as 50. What is that you need? Q. Okay. It is condition for maximum discharge. For condition of maximum discharge, you have to remember the formulas. I have told you already. One is theta, which is 154 degrees. And next, small d, and also in terms of m. So, right, according to maximum discharge condition, theta is 154 degrees, small d is 0.95 times capital D, and m is 0.2860. These conditions I have explained to you in my earlier video. Again, let's start off now. So let's calculate small d first. What is small d? Depth of flow. Depth of flow is equal to 0.95 into what is capital D? 2. So let me calculate the value of small d. 0.95 into 2. It is 1.9 meters. Depth of flow is 1.9 meters. Next, let's calculate hydraulic radius, which is 0.286 into d. So which implies into what is capital D? 2. So let's calculate for m. 0.286 into 2. Yeah, it is 0.572 meters. That's your hydraulic radius. Now, let's start calculation of Q. What is Q formula? AC root MI. So, for AC root MI, you require A. That's all. Why? Because M, I and C are already. Let's calculate area. So, for calculation of area, you have two methods. One is directly taking the formula of area, which is r square by 2 theta into theta minus sine 2 theta by 2, or else you can just do from m as we have done in our just earlier problem. So first let's calculate wetted perimeter. Wetted perimeter P is equals to, what's the formula? 2 r theta. Okay, so here let's calculate first theta. Theta is here is in degrees. I already told you, when you are doing substituting the value of theta without any trigonometric function, you have to convert it into radians. So into pi by 180. So let me check the value of theta, how much it will be. I'm showing you here. See, it is 154 into shift pi by 180. 2.68 radians is theta value. Now let's calculate what is P. P is equals to 2r theta. What is 2 into r? It's diameter only, no? So directly 2 into 2.68. Let's calculate what is P. Yeah, it came out to be 5.37 meters. Once you get weighted perimeter, take the formula of hydraulic radius, which is A by P. So from here, calculate what is A, M into P. So M is how much? 0.572 into P is 5.37. Let's calculate what is A. So 5.37 into 0.572. Yeah, it is 3.074 meter square. Now everything is ready. Just putting the formula of Q, you'll get Q. So Q is equals to AC into root MI. So A is how much? 3.074 into what is C value given to us? 50 into root of N is 0.572 into what is I given to us? 1/1500. So let's solve for Q. I mean, doing it here, just you can have a look. Yeah, 3.074 into 50 into root of, no, sorry, into root of 0.572 by 1500. It's 3 meter cube per second. Okay, so this is how you need to calculate the discharge, and this is the last model in most economical circular sections. Hope you understood this video, and thank you.